guys, thank you so, so much for being with me today. In this video, I am going to be tackling Oprah's favorite things, her favorite beauty things. As you guys probably know, every year around this time, she comes up with her list of favorite things. I noticed this year, it all appears to be on Amazon. I will link below so you can like see everything that's on there. I mean, there's everything from toaster ovens and panini presses to the kinds of things that I'm talking about in this video. So I noticed she had a category for beauty. I thought it would be fun to get some of these things that Oprah says are her favorites, try them out, and give you my perspective on them. And I would also really like to know, how does Oprah come up with all this stuff? Like, does she have maybe, I don't know, some editors from her magazine or just some close friends that are kind of discussing this all with her? Because it's truly a really varied list of things that are on her favorites. But full disclosure here, I love Oprah. Like, I've really, especially lately, been into listening to her Super Soul podcasts and everything, Super Soul Conversations. I think those are great. If Oprah said to jump off a bridge, I'm not saying I'd do it, but I would probably think about it. I love her, I respect her, but I'm going to give you my true, honest thoughts that you come to my channel to find. I'm gonna give that to you in this video. First thing is from the brand called Kaylin, and it's the Oh Wow brushes. So I got one of these, I ordered one. What I have here is called the Double Brush. She says, these high quality makeup brushes are a pleasure to use. They feel good in your hands and are just what you need to blend, blend, blend. So they're all sold separately. There's not like one full set. They show a few of them here in the listing of her favorite things. But I thought the best buy might be the double brush. And this is still, I mean, $37.99. So is it worth it? It is kind of a cool idea here because you've got the one fully blunt cut flat top side, and then the other has a little bit of a taper. And you might think, is that a little small for doing foundation? I actually found it to be perfect. It was great for buffing in foundation. This flat side, like, it gets everywhere. I think it's a matter of how far the bristles extend from this handle, so it can really get in everywhere. And then I found myself using this other side, like, when I needed to get into some little crease areas. But I used it pretty much all for foundation and concealer. I just kind of bounced back and forth between the sides. It is a really easy to use handle here. You see the bend in it, and then kind of a wider base, so there's plenty to hold on to. It's very easy to get everywhere. The quality is super duper soft. I see no signs of shedding, but I truly do love the two brushes in one concept because one is a great buffer, I think, for the more flat planes of the face, and the other is great to get around all the nooks and crannies. This could obviously be a good like cream contour too. I did that as well. I found it a bit more bunglesome, I guess, to blend the cream contour because you really don't want to turn it this way, and then you might widen out the path of your contour a bit too much. If you keep it sideways, you're okay. But my absolute favorite things to do with this were by far foundation and concealer. The way it comes, it's in this box. It slides out of a sort of velvety or faux velvet type tray. And then there is a little cap here, which I think is cool because this could be kind of an odd thing to travel with perhaps, but it just snaps right down like, you know, a toothbrush cover or something. Here's been my personal experience. There are other brushes on the market, some very affordable ones. Like if you want to look at iKate House's website, this side that has the taper, that seems to be the go-to shape for these brushes from like the Artiste line that first put them out and then all the other brands that have come to follow. This kind of rounded off, super tapered design seems to be what they're going for. But this has been the first brush of this kind that I've tried with the just blunt cut end. So if the tapered side appeals to you more, you might be able to find a better value elsewhere, although I have not tried anything that's like this. And as you can see, as I've rubbed these on my hand, the tapered side doesn't have a lot of movement. The blunt side is where it really moves with your skin, and that's why a brush this small can still be so good for blending in foundation. So I really did enjoy this a lot. I think Oprah's got a great pick going here, and I'm actually a little bit curious about some of the others that are available in this line. Oh, and by the way, I did purchase everything in this video myself. I am not in cahoots with Oprah, although Oprah, if you'd like to get in cahoots about something, just let me know. Okay, when I saw Oprah had a must-have lip product, I had to go for it. And granted, I could have bought just a few of these individually and maybe given you my take on the formula, but I wanted to try the whole shebang that she said she liked. And it's Julep Beauty's It's Whipped Limited Edition Lip Mousse Vault. So this is what it looks like, guys. It says matte lips don't lie. This is on Amazon, but I got mine on Ulta's website just because I wanted the, you know, know, the Ulta points and everything. But this is what's inside. 25 whipped lip products. And I was a little scared at first because I thought, if I don't like this formula, you know, I spent $250 on it. And what if I don't like what this is? I took a major leap of faith in trusting Oprah on this one. The reason why a few of these are standing up is because I wanted to mark the ones that were my favorite shades in the whole bunch. And yes, you are gonna see me trying on every one of these shades for you. The regular line is smaller than this. So this box incorporates their permanent shades and also some extra shades. Here's what Oprah said about it. I just ordered a bunch of these sets of 25 matte lip shades for every woman I know, including myself. You're going to want to kiss yourself. And I'm really picky with lip color textures, especially these matte liquid lipsticks. Some of them I have no patience for, you know, like the ones that just dry down and they feel completely uncomfortable. I am so thrilled to say that I love this formula. It's a combination of a wonderful formula and also the delivery method or the tip, you know, the way it goes on your lips is so good. So the shade I'm wearing out of this bunch is Pucker Up, and it truly is this mousse formula. There's a little bit of dry down with this, although it's not uncomfortable at all. If you've tried Bare Minerals Gen Nude, it's a really similar feeling going on, only maybe a little bit more lightweight than those, a little more mousse-like and less liquefied. And I think being so moussey and light, it keeps these true to color because it's not going straight up liquid to dry. And because when that happens, I think that's when the colors start to change with a lot of liquid lipsticks. So this very much stays like what you see is what you get. But I would say within a few minutes of having this on your lips, you start to feel a little bit of dry down. Okay, so it just gets a hair bit drier, and it's still super comfortable. Like, you can still press your lips together, you feel moisture there, you feel like little beads of moisture still present on the lips. Like, I've already had this on for an hour or so this morning, and it still feels that way when I press my lips together. But the design of the applicator is so good. I love this little hourglass shape, okay? So in the depth of the hourglass, that's where a lot of product is held, and also at the tip. And this tip is so genius for getting out to the edge and doing it so quickly. I have never had a faster liquid lipstick application than this. And what I find myself wanting to do is take the center, the depth of the hourglass where it's kind of cutting in there, and get that right there on the lower lip to deposit some product. And then I use the tip kind of as my lip liner, and it just gives you the perfect edge. It's not like a soft edge. I'm not sure how it's doing it because it's a super precise edge to my lip that's not super pointed and like, oh, you gotta be so careful and watching it so closely. Like, it just kind of rolls out to the outside of the lip, and it's so easy. And I even was applying one of these shades to my mom, and she's like, you're already done? I think she was expecting it to be a more painstaking application. She's used to using the CoverGirl Outlast stuff. And so I'm like, Mom, you gotta try this. We're gonna see if it fades and drifts up outside your lip line. And I gave her a pretty vivid shade. I put her in XOXO, which is kind of a rich pinky shade. And I'm like, I want you to tell me if you feel like this is getting uncomfortable. Like, is it drying to an uncomfortable place? And we both kind of agreed that while there was a bit of dry down from the initial application, it still stays feeling very, very comfortable. Not like a separate layer of something on your lips. She thought it felt super lightweight, but the real like thing that was gonna make it a hit or miss for her was whether or not it faded up into the lines around her lips. And so later that night after she'd had dinner, she texted me and gave me an update on it. She said, lipstick wore some on inner lip while eating, but really no bleeding in lines at all. Very good. And we've all got little avenues, little lines around our lips where if bleeding is going to happen with a certain product, it can happen on about anybody. I have not seen it happen to me either. The colors stay in place really well. I don't think they wear off in a patchy or uneven way. I mean, I'll show you a shade. I wore one of the reds and then I had pizza. I don't think there's a much better test for the staying power of a product than pizza. I mean, you got the grease, you've got the just your mouth getting all over it factor. And after eating it, yeah, there was a little wear down, but it's so even. The fact that this is not like one of those liquid lipsticks that is a total separate layer on your lips, it becomes a little more one with the lips. The color really hangs on. I've been so happy with these. Now, there is something I will point out about some of the shades that have shimmer. At a glance, I can tell more easily when I look at this lineup because the shimmery ones are very easily marked with a little bit of a finish here. So there's this soft color called Blush, which I think these might be good layering type products and maybe maybe that's what these were created to do, was to be worn a little bit more hand in hand with the others. But like the other day I was wearing Basio, and it's this kind of shimmery neutral brown, and I found that it wore off faster and it just didn't look quite as even going on. I mean, it still looked kind of cool. It's not the same texture as the full-on just creamy mattes. So blush, Basio, and then there's Blind Date, has a little bit of a sheen, but I really like that shade. Then there's Spark and Love Potion, which I liked a little better because they had more pigment to them. So I'm not sure how I'm going to edit this exactly, but I did want you to see all of the shades on my lips so you could see what the full spectrum looks like, you know? You've got everything in here from soft pinks, some really wearable, just medium, like dusty rose type shades, kind of a lilac-y taupe type color, a nice little handful of bright reds with varying undertones. You've got pinks, really nice fuchsia, magenta, purpley pinks, several plums, and some really dark vampy shades as well. So it's like a really true spectrum of stuff happening. I think it's a very well-rounded collection. I wanted to point out just for fun a few of my favorite shades. I really like Pillow Talk. This is going to be a soft, kind of natural looking pink. I've described this type of shade as winter pink before. I've also got a couple of shades here that I think anybody could reach for and enjoy. One is called Say Hello, and it's kind of a little bit brownish tan nude. Also some rose in there, but there's some warmth to that shade. And then Bisou, I'm holding these up side by side because they are kind of close, but this has a little less tan. It's more what I think of as true mauve. This shade just screams like watermelon to me. This one called Lip Service, I love that. Two others kind of in that reddish lineup. At Midnight is the wearable, classic, classy, little bit of depth to it. And then I also like Basso, and this one is orange. It's on fire. I love it. And with the pinks, I love Amore, or Amore maybe is how you'd say that. This is a true creamy pink with a little hint of berry mixed in. Pucker Up, which is the shade I'm wearing now. I mean, isn't that gorgeous if you like the purpley kind of violet? And then an awesome rich plum is Dare. So Dare is going to be darker than this, but very like appropriate to the season. I love that. So I'm really glad that I'm coming away enjoying the vault. I love the vault. I'm glad I have it, but even if you don't get that whole vault, you might just, I don't know, test out a couple of shades of this, or maybe if they have even smaller giftable trios or something like that, I'll link to those below as well. But this is fun. Y'all know I'm the kind who likes to have the whole rainbow to experiment with, and this is really cool. Another thing that I got is a body type set, and it's from Foot Nanny. They had this trio for $50 that Oprah had in her favorites, and it's called Fresh Linen, and this is what you get. It came in a nice little white box. Like, it looked very giftable right off the bat. White box, little like red bow going around the corners. Oprah says, everybody loves the smell of clean. How they got it in a bottle, I'll never know. The linen scent of this shower gel hand soap and lotion developed by Gloria Williams, aka the Foot Nanny, reminds me of slipping between freshly laundered sheets. So I'm with her on that. These smell really clean. These products seem to be the kind of thing that anybody could use. They would not be objectionable to anyone. I think this might be a good like guest bathroom type trio of things. You are getting the hand and body lotion, also the hand soap, and then there's the shower gel. And these are all plastic bottles, by the way. Now, while I do like it, I think the scent is pleasant. It is fresh. It's super clean. I'm not blown away. I'm instantly thinking of something similar to this scent. The brand Clean has a scent called, I think it's Warm Cotton or something. I find that scent a little more rich, just more potent. I get a little more scent satisfaction out of that, and it's this kind of scent. This is very light. I mean, that's why I think it could be good for just about anybody. Man, woman, and child could use it and not be too overwhelmed. The hand soap is fine. Got the job done, you know. I'll keep using that. The shower gel was just okay. I mean, I've used cheaper kinds that have done a little bit more in terms of really lathering up. And like I said, the scent is very subtle. The hand and body lotion was nice, and I was able to use this on my hands. With some products, the scent is so much that it causes like little breakouts practically, or an allergic reaction on my hands. It is nice. It's very fresh and clean, and if you truly want to do the fresh and clean scent, it probably shouldn't be too strong, but I could take just a little more, I don't know, strength to the scent, I guess. It's nice, but I'm not like as excited about this as I am, for example, my Philosophy duo that I got, the holiday pajamas, shower gel, and lotion. Like, that scent really gets me. The last thing I want to tell you about that I tried is the Toka or Taka, I'm not sure how to say this brand, but it's the hand cream. It's a 4-ounce size, so it's a pretty good size for for a hand cream, and it comes in a variety of scents. I chose the scent Guletta, I think is how you say it. It's the pink tulip and green apple. It's a really gorgeous tube, and the box is very beautiful as well. It says, enriched with natural extracts from coconut oil, shea butter, and aloe, this moisturizing hand cream will leave your skin feeling soft and silky, and it is paraben-free. Let's see what Oprah has to say about it. She says, not sure what to get a nice neighbor or your kid's social studies teacher. These hand creams are rich, quick absorbing, and deeply soothing. I tried it, Tyler tried it, my dad tried it, my mom tried it. We all agreed that the hands felt extremely silky smooth after putting this on. The scent on this is very fresh. I don't know that I would have picked out the fact that it was pink tulip specifically and green apple. I'm not getting a ton of green apple out of that. If nobody told me what this was supposed to smell like, I would just say it smelled lightly floral, maybe, but just kind of fresh, really. For me, this is mostly about texture because a small amount of this, I think, goes a long way and it absorbs really quick and I don't feel greasy afterwards. My family and I kind of came to the conclusion that you can overdo it with this product. Like if you apply too much, sure, you're gonna touch your smartphone and start to get some smudging going on there. Mom always says she's using her hands hard. She really liked this stuff. But just a small dab of this is all you need. I think it's really top-notch quality. You just come away feeling soft, not like you just put lotion on. So that's it, guys. That's everything that I tried beauty-wise from Oprah's favorites. She's obviously got some good taste. For me personally, I would say 3 out of the 4 things were really successes for me. My number one find would be the Julep lip products. That's a brand that I'm going to have to just start looking at more. They've got some good stuff. Clearly. My number two favorite would probably be the Oh Wow Double Brush from Kaylin. I mean, I really enjoyed the way this blended out my foundation. I'm going to keep using this a lot, but if you're just kind of curious about the paddle style brush in general and you don't want to spend like over 30 bucks on one, there are plenty of other brands that are making little knockoffs, at least of this kind of shape, that you could test out and see if you liked it. The hand cream, honestly, great gift for anyone. And then the thing that I was just kind of like underwhelmed with, I guess, was the fresh linen trio of products. This may be a great brand for other things, but I don't know. For 50 bucks, yeah, I think anybody could like this scent well enough, but I just wasn't super excited about it. So thank you guys so much for taking time to watch. I hope this was helpful and fun, and I will see you in my next video. Bye.